An 8-1 victory here tonight in Chatham as the Commodores pick up another road victory here on the season. David Hadar here alongside Matt Levine. Thanks for joining us here this evening on Closing the Door. Matt, a great night here tonight for the Commodores as they pick up the victory here in Chatham. Their first victory over the Anglers this season. Their first victory over a team from the Eastern Division. And on top of that, they pick up their fourth overall win on the year. Just a great night overall here for Falmouth.
Well, up and down the score sheet, just a complete game. We said it a little bit ago, early in the season, they probably had their most complete game. Tonight was. They had their best start by a pitcher tonight, probably two of their best outings in the bullpen as well, and their offense collectively as a whole was phenomenal all night, scoring 8 runs on 11 hits. The defense had that one error from Michael Curiale. Other than that, pretty clean, I would say. So really up and down in the three facets of the game, they were really good tonight.
You talk about the starting pitching. Trey McLoughlin making his first official start here tonight for the Commodores. He went 5 scoreless innings, and those 5 innings, the longest outing by any starting pitcher this season for Falmouth, and those scoreless runs over 5 innings, also the best stretch of scoreless baseball for the Commodores this season.
Well, he doesn't throw that hard. He didn't dominate anybody. He only had 4 strikeouts, but to go that long and to keep hitters scoreless, and they were on the bases for the most part. Gave up a couple hits, 2 innings in a row that Chatham stranded 2 runners on base. But to get those runners on and then strand them is such a good job on the mound. And McLoughlin, again, doesn't overpower, but he used that to his advantage. He locates his fastball well and drops in that breaking ball when he needs to. And it was the best start by a Commodore this season so far.
And through, the entire pitching staff tonight pitched well for the Commodores, only allowing 1 run. That was off of Anthony DeFabia, but it was not an earned run for him. All right, let's flip it around now to the offense tonight for Falmouth. 8 runs brought across by this team. Another dominant performance led by Braden Taylor tonight, who went 3-for-4 at the plate, brought home a huge bases-clearing double in the 8th inning, and that just padded the Commodores' lead for this evening.
Well, we've seen him step up in big spots pretty much all season long. He's been in that 3 spot every game. He's either been around the infield or the DH. He's been the DH the last 3 nights, and he's been on base in every game except for last night. So tonight, he starts in the first inning with a single, comes around to score, and ends up with probably the biggest hit of the night. It was a close game, if you really think about it, a 3-run lead, and he made it a 7-1 ball game in the 8th inning on an 0-2 pitch that he took inches away from being a home run off the top of the fence in right center. Just such a good player. He's really shining on the Cape this season so far, and I think one of the best players in the league that we've seen so far.
Falmouth now 4-0-1 on the road this season. That only tie came last night up in Wareham, a 3-3 draw for both sides. But they get another victory here on the road tonight, now 4-0-1 on the season. Just talk about for a moment how well the Commodores have been playing on the road this year.
I don't know what it is. I think it might be that they're able to hit first. That might be the difference, where the last 2 nights we've seen this, the last 3 nights rather, they score in the first inning, and then they come back and have their pitcher have a lead. Going out with a lead on the mound is a different mentality than starting it at home when it's 0-0 and all eyes are on you as a pitcher when you're going out there to start it in the top of the first. Rather, having the offense go first and really putting the pressure on and scoring those early runs, that's where they've gotten some of that good success early in games, that they've taken that momentum and put it to the later innings. And it's really been good for this team to hit first in the last 3 games, and they've shown that that's what's really helped them get victories.
The offense started things tonight with 2 runs in the first inning. Trey McLoughlin then ran with it for the rest of the way as he went 5 scoreless innings, and he's now joined alongside our sideline reporter, Joanne Bethea.
Thanks, guys. I'm here with starting pitcher Trey McLoughlin. Tonight could arguably be one of the best starts Falmouth has had. What was allowing you to be so successful?
Felt really good in the bullpen today. My off-speed stuff was good. Curveball, changeup was feeling really good, and I think I located my fastball pretty well.
When Coach Landry came out on the mound in the 5th and you didn't go out, what was that conversation like? What did you say to him to convince him to let you stay?
He was just telling me to slow it down, and I was getting a little bit out ahead of myself, a little excited. Just told me to slow it down, stay within myself, and get after it.
Awesome. You come from a small school compared to a lot of the guys on the team. What is it like being from an environment like yours compared to maybe some of the guys from larger D1 schools?
It's been a lot of fun. I've learned a lot. I've picked their brains about a lot of different stuff. So I've definitely learned a lot. That's probably the biggest takeaway.
Thank you. From Veterans Field, Falmouth takes down Chatham 8-1. We will finally be home tomorrow. Joanne Bethea, I'm closing the door for Matt Levine, David Dore, and myself.